Okay, so the question says that we've got a data logger, which basically has received, sorry, a computer receives data from a data logger. Each data block is a group of 8 bytes. A block is made up of 7 digits, so we've got 1 to 7, and a parity byte. Each data, so the parity byte is down here. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 here. We've also got here where the 0 is a parity bit. So how does the data logger calculate the parity bit? Well, it basically, in our scenario, is using odd parity. So it will count all the ones going up to from position 1 to position 7 of a bit, of a byte, sorry. So it'll count 1, 2, 3, 4. That'll give you even. So therefore, position 0, which is the parity bit, will be a 1 to make it odd. So your answer would be it counts the number of 1 bits between position 1 and position 7. Position 0 will then either be a 0 or 1, depending on what it needs to be to make it an odd number. That is what this question is basically saying you to t write out those steps. So A and B is pretty simple. A would be 1 because we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. And B would be also 1 because we've got 4 again. Describe how a computer uses parity byte. So we've got bits up here. We've got the parity byte down here. A further check on the received data byte to perform a further check on the received data byte. Step one. What we need to do is do a parity bit for each column. So here, here, here by doing a calculation here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is odd, therefore we need to put a 0 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's even, so we need a 1 down here to make it odd. Because remember, we're transmitting using odd parity. So that's step one. A parity bit is worked out for each column. Step two is the computer checks the parity of each bit position in the parity byte. So it checks this, it checks this, it checks this, it checks this, it checks this. And then what it'll do, it will do a comparison to see if there's any, what's the word I'm looking for? Inconsistencies. If there's an incorrect parity, so let's imagine that when it adds up all of this for each one, and it does a comparison, so it takes this parity byte and it compares it to the data which is sent. So if I'm sending, this is me, Mr. L, and this is Julie. I send Julie the data with a parity byte. Julie will then perform her own parity check. So PC for parity check. She'll compare her parity byte with my parity byte. If there's incorrect parity, then there's an error in the data received. If there is no parity error, there's no error. Finally, the position of the incorrect bit can be determined by using the parity block. So if there's a mess up somewhere, we can find out exactly which bit has messed it up. So step one, a parity bit is worked out for each column. Step two, the computer checks the parity of each position. It compares it to what's been sent. If there is an inconsistency, so an incorrect parity, then there is a error in data received. No inconsistencies, no errors in parity, no errors in data. Finally, you can actually find the exact position of where the error is. Unlike a parity byte, if you just sent a parity byte without the parity block, then we won't be able to find the exact error. We just know that it's meant to be odd, so even. So odd even. Let's try that again. It's meant to be odd, but it's giving us an even one. But we can't find out which bit screwed up, whilst a parity block we can do. So a parity bit is worked out for each column. The computer checks the parity of each position by doing a comparison. If it's incorrect parity is found, then there's an error in the data being received. If there's no parity error, no error in data received, the exact location of the bit which is incorrect can be found. That is this answer here.